Did you know if you drop a like and subscribe in the next 5 seconds, nothing will happen, but it will put a giant smile on my face. So it's safe to say in the final 50% of Chapter 2 Season 8, of which we've literally just entered, everybody's going to be looking past the soon-to-end Fortnite Mares event at the time of me recording this video, and on to more interesting things such as how this season's going to be wrapped up in terms of a storyline that's now starting to get juicy with the introduction of the Q Queen not only in-game, but soon to be revealed in terms of how we unlock her in-game, and with all the talk of everything happening to end off this season and potentially that being this chapter actually going into a new one on December 5th, 2021, I figured in today's video we'd not only cover all the things Chapter 3 that we already know about in case you guys need reminding and stuff, but how that correlates to new information about the brand new Fortnite Chapter 3 map, of which we may be flying over for the first time, straight after the trailer plays on whatever device you're playing Fortnite on, kind of like what happened in Chapter 2 as we saw the trailer and then literally were thrown onto the map. And I already know, of course, that sounds good to you, so do yourself the favour today whilst you sit back, relax, grab your favourite snack, stick around, watch the full video. It would not only make my day, but it would make my pug Gus a little bit happier, considering, yes, he still knows that 70% of all eyes on screen right now out of the viewers watching this video and others aren't subscribed. We've just surpassed 2.2 million and are aiming for 2.3 million by the end of the year. I mean, it's completely free after all, and you know what else is free? Entering code FM1, perhaps one of the shortest and easiest codes to enter inside of the Fortnite item shop, as it directly supports me as a creator, and despite this not contributing toward your chances of being gifted, don't forget that I do gift, yes, 5 subscribers every single day on this channel. So if you want to be gifted in the next video, maybe make sure you're subscribing to the channel with all notifications turned on, and then comment your Epic Games ID down below and potentially what you'd like to receive off me. And despite being one of the 5 gifted every day, you could be shown as the one on screen perhaps in the very next video I post on the channel. Just before we go any further, I need to tell you guys real quick about an amazing game I've just discovered, who are kindly sponsoring today's video, being Ace Defender. For those of you wondering what Ace Defender is, it's a high quality SRPG masterpiece combining authentic turn-based RPG battle with tower defense elements. The game has a traditional RPG storyline, solo player with 40 plus characters, nearly 2,000 levels too. In terms of the storyline contained throughout those 2,000 levels, it consists of a rebellion in the Dragon Clan that threatens the balance of good and evil in the world. The Silver Dragon Princess Alapida escaped with the Creation Crystal to the Human Lands, and from there she awoke the Creation Crystal and summoned heroes to fight evil with your help. In terms of the heroes, there are 5 factions: Divine, Demon, Shadow, Nature, Light, and Deep Hero background stories. Although you're starting with 48 heroes, there's 2 new heroes released every week, making the content and game also fresh and fun to play all the time. And of course you can level up, combine heroes, and equip gear to create a powerful lineup. In terms of gameplay modes, you can go at your own pace by speeding it up or slowing it down with 1x, 2x and 4x gameplay. If you're predominantly a solo player and like venturing through things for yourself, then Expedition is definitely a choice for you. In PvE, you can explore dungeons, regions, engage in trials, level up your heroes and collect rare items. And of course then, if you build up the confidence to go against other people, in PvP you can fight against other players within your server, arena, or across servers, King's Arena, with multiple lineups. Perhaps the best part of you downloading this right now from clicking the link at the top of the video description or in the pinned comments is the fact that newcomers who download the game from clicking either link will get 10 Royal Recruit tickets after completing level 2 to 8, and you can use these free rewards, being the tickets, by clicking Sky City, Tavern, and then Recruit 10x. I definitely know what I'm doing tonight, so make sure to click the link either in the pinned comment or video description and join me on this journey. Okay, so one of the first things to note of, considering on Tuesday the 26th of October when I'm uploading this video, the 18.30 update should have gone live, which is also the second to last downtime update, believe it or not, of Chapter 2 Season 8, considering Epic Games, for whatever reason, according to Sheena, have actually scrapped 18.50, meaning whatever's leaked within this update will be the second to final thing potentially of this chapter that gets revealed. As I'm recording this video before 18.30, in terms of map changes or map change developments, as it may not already happen all at once, what I'm about to show you guys in terms of a leak is the start of a pyramid forming all the way up to the Cube Queen at the Convergence area. The reason I predict before the update happens that it won't happen all at once, a giant pyramid forming or the Convergence area getting even more bigger, is because data miners, when it was initially updated into the game or even leaked during the downtime that it would be in the game when the downtime lifted, found that there's going to be stages to this, not only in terms of the progression of it, but the spread of it radially from our center point of the island. I've mentioned this in a few other videos too, to do with the next chapter or what's going to be starting in terms of a new season when this season ends. Center map changes are very important, and we've seen this change literally every time from season to season in Chapter 2, despite the start of Chapter 2 Season 8 in itself, it still remained as the Aftermath area, and we we've only just seen the Cube Town or Convergence area implemented as of recently for Fort Nightmares. Obviously, we know the Zero Point resides below here, and right now we don't really know where it is, considering Galactus brought it out of the ground, and then the mothership obviously abducted it, and now that's destroyed, so yeah, it literally could be anywhere. Fingers crossed it's not in the outskirts of the water in this mothership too, though. But anyways, in terms of why I believe they haven't implemented the map change for the Convergence or the Cube Queen or the Cube Town at the start of Chapter 2 Season 8 is because, of course, it involved the secret skin, which actually was secret until as of recently this season, with the silhouette of her only being shown initially in the Battle Pass trailer, on our coming soon section of the rewards we can earn around her, two pages of which are in here that haven't been revealed even yet when I'm recording this video, and of course we heard her voice in the Season 8 Battle Pass trailer. With Epic Games revealing her to be based around the Fort Nightmares event anyways, or responsible for more darkness coming to the island in terms of these big bosses that we can either defeat in the sideways or in the Horde Rush LTM, and with her being behind all the dark and sinister sideway based map changes anyways, also contributing to Fort Nightmares, with her literally being the theme of both Fort Nightmares trailers despite the one just primarily surrounding her or introducing her into the Fortnite storyline itself. Of course, this now makes more sense for her to be introduced at the Fort Nightmares event or when it actually starts anyways, as it wasn't the time for Fort Nightmares to start at the very beginning of Chapter 2 Season 8. Speaking of her in terms of a map change though, inside this sphere above the Convergence or Cube Town area in itself though, if we compare the size of us to her, believe it or not, she actually outsizes us, like nearly 4 times as much as a normal character. I literally built up to her and danced there and obviously got replay shots so you don't have to. And the interesting thing about how she's appeared or what she's going to be doing here hovering in the sky in this sphere is the resemblances that it has to an event that occurred in our prior chapter that we didn't entirely understand at the time, but was a first for Fortnite live events, even with them being a first for gaming history in itself and event occurring live in game, I guess. The event I'm referring to, obviously, as you've seen, is the Ice Storm event with the Ice King inside this giant sphere, again harnessing cube shards and the power of them to raise a giant hologram version of himself in the water, and then sweeping the map once he breaks out of the sphere and raise the giant version of himself, covering it all in snow. With the resemblance of the build-up of this Ice Storm event obviously kind of being reflected through the Cube Queen, but her being much bigger than the Ice King was, considering we can tell from clips here that yes, we were the same size as the Ice King inside this sphere in Chapter 1 Season 7. Many people not only believe that she's going to have more power from, yes, harnessing what we can even see now to be cube shards, again like the Ice King held, from obviously her being a taller or bigger character in herself, but yeah, raising another, even perhaps more giant version of herself, maybe even Galactus's size instead of what the Ice King managed to pull off, and then destroying the map or turning it fully into darkness with nothing remaining, as she also said was her intention in the Chapter 2 Season 8 trailer, to intimidate us as the Battle Royale player inhabitants. And with us speculating based off the fact we know Chapter 3 is going to be a completely new map, and with nothing mentioned about Chapter 2 Season 9 or Chapter 2 Season X, and instead with the Season 8 leaks kind of all coming true now, leading up to the final things to remain to come true on this list being the Chapter 3 intel. Of course, in Chapter 1 with us having Seasons 1 to 10, and with this chapter already going on for longer in just 8 seasons, not even fully complete, than those 10 seasons in themselves in Chapter 1, as it's literally been out Chapter 2 for over 2 years. I know, literally, 2 years since we saw these trailers. Honestly, time flies. This then is leading players to believe, obviously, what the Cube Queen is managing to do right here, despite this point also backing it up in itself individually from the list, that she's going to be largely involved in Chapter 3, the secret skin from Season 8, that she's going to be destroying this map, or at least getting it on the way to be destroyed anyways, kind of like a half event where perhaps we're sucked into a black hole from her not literally just destroying this island, but the entire dimension spitting us into a new one, kind of like we saw from the black hole from Chapter 1, obviously sucking in that map and then creating a new map when the dimension expanded in Chapter 2. It's very possible we go into one of these states again of actually being transferred to a brand new island, considering Fortnite's popularity actually peaked, as you can see right here, the Fortnite search term on Google Trends over the past 5 years, and yep, the high spike literally, our most noticeable one was when the end event occurred and we were in this black hole for 48 hours, only able to play this very frustratingly repetitive minigame. Despite it being frustrating, it was the only thing to do at the time, everybody was streaming it, playing it, waiting for something to happen with this black hole on the edge of their seats, and yeah, I was one of them people, I managed to get a million score. But yeah, from looking at the popularity of Fortnite overall over the past 5 years, with it being in one of the lowest points it's been since 2018 in terms of people searching up for it or even playing it, or this being a good indicator of that, it's about time, considering Chapter 2's existed again for over 2 years, that we immediately go into a new chapter after Season 8 ends on December 5th, 2021. And despite us knowing whatever's going down with the Cube Queen is going to be affecting Chapter 3, whether it starts straight away after Season 8 or not, believe it or not, we're already actually getting leaks very early on in regards to what the Chapter 3 map may look like. Even if there is 2 more seasons, these leaks aren't to be disregarded, considering yes, the Chapter 2 map did initially get leaked way before anybody was even meant to know about it, and this came from an insider who was actually sued, and this is the initial initial image he leaked, he didn't get the name locations right in terms of their names, but the overall layout of the map, yes, you can tell this is Chapter 2. This has been floating around and blowing up on Twitter, this initial leak anyways, from people stating things such as the following: rumour this might be our first glimpse at the Chapter 3 map. According to you/EdMeyer2k on Reddit, Epic have been working on the Chapter 3 map for a while now, obviously considering, you know, we're going soon into a new chapter regardless of whether it happens after the end of Season 8 or at the end of Season X of Chapter 2, and also that the image that you see below is a concept based off what people have heard and seen from insiders obviously not being able to keep their mouth shut 100% of the time. It would be cool to see something like this. I definitely would like to play on a new Battle Royale map right about now, considering, yeah, we've only seen minor changes happen from season to season in Chapter 2. Of course, there's a ton of information on the left-hand side of this actual concept in itself, or drawing that people have managed to put together that could actually be accurate in the sense of some areas. And one of the most interesting things that stood out to me anyways is that they state Battle Royale is actually going to be 150 players per game in solos, duos, trios and squads instead of just 100 at the moment. It would make sense for us to go to a completely different map, considering Epic Games are actually going to be revamping Fortnite as we know, with the release of multiple new game modes or areas for us to play in. For instance, the Sandbox LTM, of which we got this artwork for initially, kind of more cartoon-esque than Fortnite already is. And of course, let's not forget about the modding that is eventually going to be upcoming in 2021, so Fortnite stated anyways, which again would make sense in terms of creativity, in creative mode to be implemented in a brand new chapter, and we even have leaked early gameplay or stages of this particular sandbox mode too. Let me know what it seems like to you either way in the comment section down below in terms of what's going to be happening on December 5th, considering this won't be moved this end date in terms of when the season's ending. Epic have been pretty good with their season durations or sticking to them ever since, like after Chapter 2 Season 2. And with that said, that's all the information we've got to go over in this video. So if you enjoyed, slap a like on it down below. Make sure you're subscribing to the channel if you haven't already with all notifications turned on, so that you're the first not only to get the first comment in future videos, but to soak in all the intel that I have to tell you guys. Speaking of other videos right now, however, or your next destination, make sure to interact or click with anything on screen. But most importantly, hopefully I can catch you. Yes, you, the individual still watching, I can see you. But hopefully then, in that very next video I do post on the channel.